At DCE, we really aim to create equity across our student subgroups. We have some students that are joining on campus, we have some students that are joining online, and we have other students that are joining on demand. And we thought that VR would be a really interesting experiment to see how we could create equity across all of those students. I think with this technology, we're actually bringing Harvard to the student in a way. Unlike watching a video where it'd be a 2D image and you're just sitting there watching a flat screen, you can still move about the space as the instructor is talking, as your fellow students are talking, and you feel like you're there. We worked with the vendor to create a digital twin of Harvard's campus. We took hundreds of pictures all over campus and we had them build various Harvard locations. So we had Harvard Yard, we had Widener Library, we had Sanders Theater, Annenberg Hall, and the offices of the Division of Continuing Ed. In the end, we decided to run the pilot in Carrie Foley's DGMD E55 course. The students in that course, it was actually like a great test because they were very knowledgeable about learning design. So it was asking the exact people who will be evaluating these kinds of technologies for their feedback. And we got really, really immeasurable feedback from those students.
So there's so much talk in this space about the value of VR and AR in education, but it's expensive, right? It's not fully accessible. And you have to have a certain set of skills in order to actually code for a VR experience. So naturally, there's always some hesitation to even consider it as a project. I felt like this was a really good opportunity to sort of force them to become immersed in it. And so we ended up dedicating a full week in the course. We curated a whole bunch of sort of single user experiences that they could do asynchronously on their own before they came together for a live experience where we all came synchronously together, either in headsets or in some cases, students use the desktop app. And then we left the headsets and we jumped into Zoom and we had a really rich class discussions about the opportunities and the challenges in, you know, potential projects that we might decide to do in the future.
One of the most exciting parts for me is the opportunity to really narrow the educational gap by offering these unprecedented experiences to populations of learners who wouldn't otherwise be able to access those kinds of experiences. These technologies have the ability to like really target the senses in many different ways at the same time. One of the things we found with this pilot that we kind of didn't expect to was that when you bring students together in this kind of weird and wacky and a little bit uncanny cartoony space that mimics the real world but isn't the real world, there's a goofiness and like silliness, like people don't look the way they do. They're in avatar mode. They don't move in kind of expected ways. And that actually kind of bonded the students. And so I think that piece of having a shared physical experience with folks who you might not be sitting in the same literal room with, but still being able to have that kind of interaction is actually huge.
For me, one of the most exciting things is the potential for people around the world to have access to places and experiences that they might not otherwise have access. And so while something like VR, there are some accessibility issues, there are also ways in which technology can increase accessibility. And so that is something that's really exciting for me, is to be thinking about how do we use the technology to increase accessibility for all of these learning experiences.
The debrief was amazing. Everyone just had such insightful things to say, regardless of whether or not they loved it, they hated it, they loved this but didn't like that, right? So it was just a very honest and open discussion. And that's really the whole point of this course. It was a very meta experience. I wasn't teaching them anything through a VR experience. We were evaluating what VR experiences mean for teachable moments in education, right? So we didn't design anything in particular that they had to then get tested on afterwards. Really what we were doing was they were kind of evaluating it and experiencing it for themselves.
There's just a steep learning curve, especially for people who may not have experience with technology like this before. And so it's really important as educators to be providing the resources to get them to the point where they can actually fully be using the technology and enjoying it and not having the cognitive burden of trying to figure out how to use the technology while also trying to have the learning experience. That's a really big challenge with a lot of technology, and we certainly saw that in this pilot.
You really can't design for everyone in the format. And so what we ended up doing was we wanted to make sure that no one felt left out and everyone had an equitable experience. And so we had the in-headset experiences, and then we had the desktop experiences. For those that had a headset, I said, please still try it on the desktop, because I wanted them to see the difference, because I didn't want them to think, oh, this is so immersive and so great, I can design for this, without thinking about having to design for the other group.
In 2016, our team started leveraging Zoom within the classroom to bring online students in real time. Now we're saying, I think the students actually want more immersion, right? So 8 years from now, I think we'll be looking back as like, this is like dipping our toe into this technology, getting comfortable with it. And I do think that the VR, AR, XR development is just gonna continue to increase. So we wanna be ready for when that becomes ubiquitous.